Thus, we have learned basic things regarding basic operation of signal system, introduction, and various kind of signals. Today, we will learn linear computation, which is one of the most important fundamental operations or tool of signal processing. And in fact, we can say it is most important for digital signal processing application. So, computation is a very important operation, and as an engineer, we need to understand that what does it mean physically and how to calculate convolution for different kind of input signals and different kind of system responses. So suppose one system needs here and x of n is input, y of n is output of that system. So the system transfer function, as you know, will be h of n. H of n is nothing but the ratio of output upon input. So that is y of n upon x of n. So in fact, we can say that output of this system will be convolution of input action sequence with its impulse response. We know that for generating or calculating any signal x of n, or we can say, we can write x of n as x of n is equal to x of n product with del of n minus k, summation for complete range of k, k is equal to minus k plus n k. So because we know that del n minus k is nothing but the shifted version of del of n, so if you multiply x of n with, we are going to get x of k here, and that x of k for the complete range of k will only give x of n ultimately. The same equation we can write again with some variation as x of k multiplied with del of n minus k. Both equations will result in same output, and that will be nothing but x of n. Now suppose in our case the system transfer function is h of n, that in proper word is impulse response. It means what? If x of n is an input and that is del of n, in that case, output will be h of n. Means, if input is impulse, the response of that system, it will be known as impulse response. And here, it is that, h of n. So from there, we can see that if input is del n, output will be h of n. And that is the thing we can use in this equation. In generalized form, we can say again that just to explain the system again in equation format, we know that yn is the output, and we can rewrite yn as function of x of n. So yn is nothing but function of x of n. So this x of n is here, that is the input, and yn is the output of the system, and output is a function of input. So same property we can use here, because x of n is nothing but totally it is x of k dot del n minus k. So we can rewrite that this is the function of x of n. So this will be the function of x of n. So this will result in ultimately y of n. Simple logic. Y of n is a function of x of n. So we are just putting the value of x of n equal to summation k for minus 2 plus infinity x of k del of n minus k. It means what? We are just replacing the value x of n by this total value. So from here we know that x of n is a fixed sequence. X of n is nothing but a sequence of signal. It will have some constant values. Anything, I am taking some random values. X of n can be anything, but it will always be constant. So that x of n we can use here as a constant. So instead of writing function outside here, I can write it here. Completely function of this part, and as I said that x is going to be constant sequence only, so it doesn't matter what is the value of x of k, ultimately this part will decide the final outcome or the position of output signal. So on right hand side I can write y of n is equal to this external part of function I will remove from here and I will replace it here, because x of n or x of k for total series is a constant value. So I can rewrite it here, and this equation in that case will look like somewhat like this. So now you see, the second part of this equation is nothing but, you see, it is what summation of x of k product with function of del of n minus k. So function of del n minus k is what? Is what the response to impulse, and that we already know that is called impulse response for a system. So response to impulse is written in this part, and we can replace this part with simply h of n minus k, because that indicates nothing but function of del n minus k. So this part, this much part, I will replace with h of n minus k. So this equation will become again product of x of k with h of n minus k. And this is the standard generalized equation for convolution. And this is a linear convolution. This one is a linear convolution. You see, x of k, h of n minus k, summation for k minus infinity to plus infinity. So this equation you can use for calculating convolution for any system. Or in other words, for calculating the response of any system, we can use this equation. So output y is the response of the system, x is the input, and h is the impulse response of that system. So impulse response is what? Impulse response is what? The response to impulse for a particular system. Similarly, we may have a unit step response. When input is unit step, the response will be known as a unit step response. In same manner, this is impulse response. So this is the equation we can use to calculate convolution, linear convolution for any given sequence. Whenever there is a question that calculates the system response for under certain condition, we have to use this equation. This is the only way to calculate the system response in entire DSP. Means what? Even in the case of like the processor design or filter design or any other kind of design, whenever you need to calculate the response of the system, you have to use this equation. It means what? You have to calculate convolution between the impulse response of the system and the input signal you want to apply. And the result of that will be system response. So I can simply say that system response is equal to nothing but convolution of input signal with its impulse response. Okay. So now this equation is important, and we will apply it in some numerical, and we will try to find out the exact value of the resultant part. So let me take some general equation here, that is x of n, some random x of n. Suppose it is nothing but a simple problem, it is 1 and half. Only two values are there, a very simplified problem. Then h of n is there, let it be like 2, 1, 1, and 1. So this is some random x of n and h of n is there, and now we want to calculate the system response. Means what? There is a system whose impulse response is given like this, and now new input is there, and we need to calculate the response of the system for this new input. So we have to apply the convolution equation, that is y of n equal to summation k equal to minus 2 plus infinity x of n convolution with h of n minus h of, in fact I should write here x of k h of n minus k. So x of k is nothing but you can get x of k just by putting the variable, you can by replacing the variable n with k, you will get x of k. So x of k is given to us. This is x of k. This side you have h of n minus k. So n minus k means what? First you are taking mirror image here, and then you are shifting with the variable n. So to get h of n minus k, what we have to do, we have to take first mirror image of given sequence h of n, and then we will shift and multiply. So the mirror image, if it is the normal image, you will consider it as a zero value. Then h of minus k will be nothing but, it will be 2, 1, 1, 1. But zero position is here, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Alright, so that is the mirror image. So in first instance, when n equal to 0, first of all, when n equal to 0, this equation will become x of k product with h of minus k. Now k is between minus 2 plus infinity. But we will calculate this equation only for those value of k where we are getting some magnitude. If we are getting zero results, we are not going to take those value of k. We will see it how it is. Suppose you take k equal to 0. First of all, you take k equal to 0 minus summation is there. So I am taking k equal to somewhere starting from minus 3 to plus 3. So this equation will become, if you will put this value in this equation, in this case this equation will become what? X of minus 3, h of 3 plus x of minus 2, h of 2 plus, I am just putting the variable here, I am just solving the summation here. It will become x of minus 1, h of 1 plus x of 0, h of 0. It's very simple. You can see. And then it will be x of 1, h of minus 1 plus x of minus 2, sorry, x of plus 2, h of 2 plus it will be x of 3, h of 3. You can take one or two more values if you want. I am just taking these values. Now you see there are two values given to you. This is x of n, that is x of minus k. You can compare this signal. This is actually x of k only, nothing else. So here you can see that the zero values here, x of 0 is this and x of 1 is that. Here in this case you see it is at, h of 0, h of minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. H of 0, 1, 2, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3 values are 0 for in case of h of minus k, because it is a mirror image and now this is a left hand side signal. So for this value, you put the values in this equation, x of minus 3, you see in this equation there is nothing for x of minus 3, x of minus 2 is 0, x of minus 1 is also 0, x of 0, so x of 0 is available. You see x of minus 1, nothing is there in the left hand side, so x of minus 1 is not visible, but x of 0 is there, x of 1 is there, then x of 2 is again 0. So what I will do, I will just start putting values from x of 0. So x of 0 is nothing but I will put the first value here and that is what given value is 1. Before that everything is 0. Up to here everything will be 0. Now first value is x of 0, h of 0. So what is h of 0 in this case? That is 2. We will take this value, okay? We are calculating this equation. We have replaced this equation, we have changed the value of n here, we are starting with n equal to 0, so we are getting this equation and then we are putting the values from x of k and h of minus k. So you see here the first value x of 0, 1, h of 0 is 2, plus that is x of 1, that is half, multiplied with h of minus 1, that is 1, plus, now x of plus 2, x of plus 2 is again 0. So you whatever you can solve this side, solve, but you ultimately are going to get 0 only. So the result is what? 2 plus half, that is 2.5. So this is the result for y, for n equal to 0 case. So that is y of 0 is equal to 2.5. So this is the first case, y of 0 equal to 2.5. Similarly, we can find out the values for y of 1, y of 2, y of 3 and so on. Let me try to suppose y of 1. So y of 1 means nothing but n equal to 1. I am writing y of 0 value here, that is 2.5. Now I am calculating n equal to 1 values. So in case of n equal to 1 value, this equation will become h of 1 minus k. So h of 1 minus k is what? H of 1 minus k is what? It is the mirror image of h of k, then it is shifted towards the right hand side. As I told that in case of normal signal, if our function is k plus 1, it is left shifted. And if it is a k minus 1, it is right shifted. But in the case of mirror image, it will be just vice versa. Means what? If it is k plus 1, the signal will be shifted towards right. And if it is k minus 1, signal will be shifted towards left hand side. So here in this case, it is what? Plus 1 with minus k. It's a mirror image and it's plus. So we will move towards right hand side. So now the signal is here, h of minus k. I need to draw or I need to write the values for h of 1 minus k. So h of 1 minus k will be nothing but the one time right hand side shifted. So suppose it is a 0 value, it is 1 value. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 value. At 0, right now it is 2. So it will be shifted that side. So 2 will be at first position. 1 will come on that place, so it will be 1, 1, 1. Here it will be 0, at 2 again it will be 0. So this is nothing but h of 1 minus k. So now we put the values for k in this equation and you are going to get some results. So suppose again we are writing equation for k equal to minus 3 to plus 3. So in this case, what will happen if I am starting with minus 3, x of minus 3, h of 1 plus 3. Because I am putting minus 3, it is becoming already minus, so it is becoming minus minus plus. So 1 plus 3, that is 4, plus x of minus 2, h of, I am writing directly. So it will become what? 3 plus x of minus 1, h of 2, then x of 0, h of minus 1, plus x of 1, h of, so it will be 1 minus 1, 0, then it is x of 2, h of, so 1 minus 2, so that is minus 1. Plus x of 3, h of 1 minus 3, that is 1 minus 3 is minus 2, plus x of 4, if suppose we want to put one more value, h of minus 3. So this will be the expanded equation for x of k, h of 1 minus k, and range is minus 3 to plus 3. Just put the values in this equation. You will take the value of x from this sequence. You will take the value of h 1 minus k from this sequence. So if you see here, x is 0 before 0. Means left hand side values of x is 0. So wherever x is negative, we will map these equations part equal to 0. So you see the first part up to this point is going to be 0. Because we have x of minus values here. And x of minus is 0. Now this side you have x of 0 and positive value and h is in negative side, so we will have some values this side. We need to put values. So x of 0 is 1, 1 dot h of minus 1. So h of minus 1 from here you see it is 1, 1 plus x of 1, that is again half product with h of 0. So what is h of 0? So you see in this case that is 1 only plus next value you have, that is what, x of 2 and h of minus 1. So what is x of 2 again? That is 0 only. X of 3 is 0. X of 4, 0. So you see here, x of 2, 0. X of 3 is 0 in this case. Nothing there after 1. So x of 2 is 0, x of 3 is 0, x of 4 is 0. So the remaining part of this equation will also become 0 here onwards. So we will again have this small part of calculation, and this will result in a 1 plus half, that is 1.5. So I will write here y of 1 equal to 1.5. Now I will calculate the same thing for 1 negative value of k. We have done the calculation on right hand side, I will solve it on left hand side. So what I will take, in this case I will take k n equal to minus 1. Same value n equal to minus 1. So for that we need equation h minus k. So minus 1 minus k. So that means what? This was right hand side shifted. Now we will shift equation towards left hand side. So this equation is there. The original mirror image is here. We will shift it towards left side actually. One time. So if we will shift it towards left, it will become at 0, it is 0. Then it is 2, 1, 1, 1. So it is first position, second position, third position, and that is fourth position. So this is h of minus 1 minus k. So expand this equation, put the values, you will get the result. You see here, in this case, you have something at minus 4. So rather you write limits between minus 4 to 4. So I will rewrite this equation again one more time, and this will become x of starting from minus 3, so minus 3, h of 1 minus 3. So it is h of 4 plus x of minus 2, h of, this time it will become 3 plus x of minus 1, h of 2 plus x of 0, h of 1. Because if you are writing, yeah, then what will write x of, now it was minus, so I will take positive value, x of 1, so it will become h of 0 plus x of 2, h of, I am just replacing the value here. So you see, if I x k equal to 2, it will become x of 2, and this side it will become what? H 1 minus 2. So it will be H of 1 minus 2. So it is 1 minus 2 means what? Minus 1 plus X of 3 H of minus 2 and so on. Again you see here for the X negative value minus 3 minus 2 minus 1 everything will be 0. Okay? Everything will be 0 for this much length. And again, even we do not have any value of x after position 1. So anything greater than x is 1 will be 0. So this side again, this value will be 0. Everything depends on the length of signal. You see, because x is small, so we are getting more zeros. So the product or result of this part will be x0 h1 and x1 h0. So for that, x of 0 is what? 1. H of 1 in this case is minus h of 1. Here is 0, so you are not going to get anything. H of 1 in this equation is 0, so this product will be 0. So 0 plus this one, what is the value of x of 1? That is half. What is the value of h of 0? That is, you can see in this equation, that is what, again it is what, 1. Here in this case, so h of 0 is, in this case it is again 0. So you are going to get 0 only in this case. If you are shifting it towards the left hand side, you are going to get 0. So this means what? Your y equal to minus 1 will be 0. In this manner, we can calculate entire length or entire value for the full length of y by just putting the value of x and h. So I can write it like this, y of n will be at 0, value is 2.5. At plus 1, it was 1.5, at minus 1, it was 0. You need to calculate these values by yourself. So this is what linear convolution by equation method or simple algebraic manipulation. I would solve the same equation now in a graphical manner. Those who are more interested in graphs can understand this is very simple technique. The same problem in graphical manner. So what I will do, suppose the same x is here, that was 1 and half, this was 0 value. So the graph for x will be, this is 0 value, it is 1 and at first position it is half. This is nothing but your x of n. Now your h was nothing but, h of n was given as a 2, 1, 1, 1. Okay? So we would need the mirror image of this. So let me write h of k since starting x of k so that you would understand better. So h of k is this. So h of minus k will look like, you see here, I would draw the h of k here. At 0 position it is 2, at 1, 2, 3 it is 1. So 1, 1, 1. This side, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, nothing is there. 0. After 3, this side, again 0. So this is h of k. What is this? This is h of k. So we would take the mirror image of this h of k now, and I would write, mirror image means what? I will just shift these values from that side to this side. We will fold it with respect to the 0 value, 0 position. So what I will do, I will fold it like this to this way. So it will look like at 0 position, we will have the same value which was there, that is 2. And at minus 1, we are going to get 1. At minus 2, there will be 1. At minus 3, there will be 1. And at minus 4, there will be nothing. At plus 1, there will be nothing. So this is your h of minus 3. Now as you know that the equation of this is nothing but k equal to minus 2 plus infinity x of k h of n minus k, that will result in y of n. So from this equation we have taken a mirror image, now we have to multiply and add. So you see those values which are actually overlapping for n equal to 0 calculation, if you will put in this equation n equal to 0, this will become x of k h of minus k summation outside for k is range between minus 2 plus infinity. So that will be equal to y of 0. So for y of 0, we just have to multiply x of k with h of minus k. And it is h of k and that is h of minus k. So if you want to multiply these things, it means what? We will multiply for respective positions. Here in this case at minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, there is 0. And at 2 it is 0. So you see, then overlapping between these two signals is only for single value, and that is at 0 position. Overlapping means what? In this case at 0 you have some value, in this case at 0 you have some value. In this case at minus 1 you have some value, but in this case it is 0. At minus 2 is 0, at minus 3 is again 0. So even if you have value of minus inside for h of something, you do not have values of x of negative. So it means what? You are actually multiplying respective positions. So it means what? You are multiplying 0 with these values. So the product of these things will result in 0 value. The product of this 0 cross 0 value will result in single value, and that will be 2 cross 1, so it is 2. 2 cross 1, so it will be 2. And this side again it will be totally 0. That side again, because you are actually multiplying everything with 0 only, so you will get 0. So this is the result of n equal to 0 position. Okay, simple. Less calculation. So graphical method is more simple. So it is what? For n equal to 0, we are getting 2. For this calculation, for n equal to 0, we are just getting 2. So, we can check it again here that in this case, we are just taking the value 2 at 0 position and then we are solving things. So, simply we are getting the result here. Now, if we will shift this h towards left and right side, we will get remaining values. And the shifting depends on the value of n. So for y of 1, we need to write equation like x of k, h of 1 minus k, summation k equal to minus 2 plus infinity. Okay? So for n equal to 1, we need h of 1 minus k. So h of 1 minus k is here. It means what? We need to shift this h of minus k one time towards right hand side. So this equation will become what? It will be shifted towards right hand side. So 2 will come at 1 and 1 will be here, 1 will be here, 1 will be here. So this value is shifted here, this value is shifted here, that one is here, that one is here. One time right shifted. Now we will multiply these two signals, xk with h, 1 minus k. So you see again where is the overlapping? This time you see the overlapping is for multiple values. For these dotted lines, for in between these values, there is an overlapping. Anything outside is 0. So you see here, for 0 position, there is an overlapping. For first position, there is an overlapping. So the value at 1 is 2, value at 0 is 1 for h of 1 minus k. Here in this case for 0 it is 1, for 1 it is half. Everywhere else there is no overlap. So if you will multiply these two things, 0 will be multiplied this, so 1 will be multiplied with 1, so it will be 1 cross 1. This side 2 will be multiplied with half, so it will become 2 cross half and it will become 2 again. Because this half is there, so half will be multiplied with 2 and 2 plus half is 2. So ultimately the result is going to be what? You are going to get 1 plus 1, that will ultimately result in 2. So the value of y of 1 is 2. And similar manner, we can also calculate the value for h of minus 1 minus k. Only thing is that we need to take mirror image of h of k and we will shift it towards left hand side. So if I can shift the original h of minus k with towards left hand side, that signal will look like here is the 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, here it is 1, 2, 3. So the values will be shifted towards left hand side, so it will become what? 2, 1, 1 and 1. It is at minus 3, it is at minus 4 position. And this side we have nothing, this side we have nothing. So you see in this case there is no overlapping. Is there any overlapping? You see? Because this time signal is starting from minus 1 onwards and that signal is starting from 0 onwards. And right hand side. So what happens actually, there is no overlapping between these two values. So for this value of x of y of minus 1, you are going to get 0 value. y minus we are going to get as a 0 value. So in this way you can shift. Now we need not to calculate y of minus 2, because once it is 0 at this position and we know that there is no more overlapping, no more possibility of overlapping, so it will be 0 only. So we can, what we can do directly, we can only take negative values and then leave these values. So we need not to move towards left hand side anymore, but we need to move towards right hand side. So the sequence of y of n will be like this. At 0 position the value is 2, or yeah, it was 2. At 1 position it was 2. At minus 1 position it was 0. This side again it is 0. There may be some values on this side. So this is the graphical method. It's more simple. If you solve it carefully, it's more simple than the equation method. Though both are identical things, we are solving the same thing in a different manner. The result should be similar. The point is that whichever way you are comfortable will be suitable for you. So this is called linear convolution, and this is very important. As I said, most of the times in this equation you will be using linear convolution for calculating system response.